There are more than 2,000 of islands in Estonia, but this one have unique ecosystem called Alvar, which support large biodiversity. In the past, Estonia had 1/3 of the world alvars, but since then, this habitat significantly diminished.
And we're burning trees here to save these grasslands for alvars.
We started from old port of Virtsu, and we have to be sure that we have enough supplies for at least 4 days, because the island is practically uninhabited and there is nothing there. Kesselaid is only 7 kilometers away, and if the weather is good, we can reach it in less than 1 hour.
In the Alvars, the layer of the soil is very thin, and underneath there is a limestone, which makes the soil calciferous. It means that it has a lot of calcium in the soil. And this is suitable for many plants, for example, wild orchids. Alvar is a semi-natural landscape. This means that it has evolved side by side with human activity, with grazing. But since traditional farming has disappeared in Estonia, these open landscapes are starting to disappear because they are being overgrown with brushwood or junipers.
Most of the alvars today are located on coastal areas and islands, and that's exactly why we're here.
We just arrived at the island and look at this car. We put our stuff inside and ready to go to our camping site. It's quite nice little island.
Our main goal is to restore grasslands because it promotes species diversity.
We set it up the camp. My tent is there. Others are all scattering around. Here's one more, which is nice because people can have privacy, like in between the bushes, and then we have also area for food cooking. And behind me there is a colony of cormorants.
And that's why we're here in August, because we want birds to nest in peace. And also most of the orchids already bloomed, so we won't be disturbing birds or walking over plants.
That's how every morning looks like. We wake up having a breakfast and then going to the working site, which is actually on the opposite side of the island, but it only takes about 15 minutes walking. I think you can walk around the whole island in about 1 hour. It's very small.
These are the junipers that we will be cutting down.
All of these big ones?
Yeah, in the past all of this was this totally open landscape, so all of the junipers have grown during the Soviet era. Naturally this island has been without trees. So when you keep the landscape open, it will be very rich in plant species. And when you already have a lot of plants, there will be a lot of insects, butterflies, beetles and so on. But in these juniper bushes, you will only have junipers and nothing else, only monoculture.
And so we started. Our first task was to burn all of the trees left from the last years, because it was very dry summer. Unfortunately, it's not possible to use this wood, as here are no people on this island. Also, to transport it to mainland will take a lot of work and time and burn a lot of fossil fuels.
So that's the thing with the burning wood, because these piles, and actually there are way more behind me, that's all from the last years. But for the whole year no one was using them and they just stay here.
And now it's time to cut some fresh junipers.
Come close, even like few meters to this fire, you start to boil. Yeah, so far we're doing great. Even the kids, they're working quite a lot. For them it's like a play, but it's very nice to see them also. Now it's break, and to save some time we decided to prepare food right here. So We're gonna make another fire, small one. It's nice that you can cook also right here in the nation.
Coastal meadows have been restored for quite some time in Estonia, like the last 20 or more years. But the biologists saw that like the specific birds that live on these areas are not coming back. They discovered that even when you leave some junipers on the area, it means that foxes, raccoon dogs, eagles, this is like a hiding place for them, the junipers. And when the foxes are in the area, they eat all the eggs on the ground, all the chicks. So in order to restore a coastal meadows for the coastal birds, you have to take down everything. It has to be like completely open without any juniper trees.
On this island there is no electricity, no running water, no sewage. We have to wash our dishes right in the sea. And that was one of the main reasons why all of the people left. Because on the mainland and on nearby island like Saaremaa, the living conditions become much, much better. And right now, here on the whole island lives only one woman in this house.
So it's like this.
So this is the fridge?
Yeah, this is the fridge.
The next day I was promoted to the tree cutter.
And now I'm using the cutter and that's like the only area left. Left and we are done. We also kept some of the apple trees and yeah, it's really hard and demanding work. I'm quite tired to be honest, but it feels great. You did something valuable and look, that's a nice and clean field.
Strange. I've never seen such a dense bit of junipers before. I guess when there's just nothing going on for long periods of time, then nature takes over. But now, look at this. Yeah, this will be a nice grassland for lots of insects and birds and so on. I think it's a good result. I didn't expect that we'd do so much.
The area in a blue color, that's what we managed to clear just in a few days. And here's the view before and after. But we're still missing the final and the most important element, without which nothing going to work.
And now, as we cut the junipers, sheep will be grazing here and they will eat the small sprigs of the junipers.
Without sheep, in 10 years the trees will overgrow again and it will look exactly the same. That's why it's called semi-natural habitats.
You're helping yourself through helping nature, because in order for the people to have a good life, you need to have biodiversity. Because when one species dies out, it will affect another species and another species and another species, and then eventually we will be the ones whose life quality will go down.
Here's another video of grassland restoration I did in Croatia. If you fancy to burn some trees, links to the ELF website will be under this video. If you like my videos, subscribe to my channel or support me on Patreon. Thank you for watching and be brave to act.